Hello YouTube, it's Saturday, March 17th. I'm gonna make another video on the NEOs, seeing as how we got another close passage scheduled here for a little while. April 1st is when they're calling for it. That would be this one right here. And they have the latest one out, came out on the 17th early this morning. 4 days now, they got 40 observations, and calling for it to be about 0.6 lunar distance away, or that many AU away, and that many AU away is about 143,843 miles, and they're getting it's down to condition code 7 now, so it's starting to be more sure of its orbit. And, first, I thought I'd go in and talk about Neumeyer Station a little bit. Now, if you remember back last year in April, I started looking at this because people were talking about this object right up here. And if you looked at it back then, you saw a few frames where it actually came in between the building and the camera, like this one here. And once it did that, it was obvious that it was nothing but lens flare. And so most of us wrote it off as lens flare, and that was it a long time ago. But it's surfaced again. Now it's doing the same thing, and it's putting out the little reflection over here, and seems like every time it does, it's over here in a certain position, right about due east is where it is. And last year I went through there and looked at it, and we looked at the bearings and whatnot, and determined that when the flare comes up, I guess you call it a reflection, the moon is getting pretty close to east. You can see just a little bit of the glow right here. But it even works with the sun too now, because the sun started showing a couple of those. And you can see when I turn the exposure all the way to the lowest setting on my camera, I got a really bright moon there. It almost looked like the same thing they saw on there. If I can get it to show, there you go. It shows almost the same thing that they're showing on there. That's with the exposure set the lowest setting on mine, the longest exposure possible on my video camera. So what they have at Neumeyer, they got two cameras that are set to show things that are really dim so they can see at night, and they got one camera that's set for a different setting. But here it is again right here, and again the moon is right over here. And this is lit by moonlight. It's at night, and it looks like daytime because the camera is setting with an exposure setting to where it can see real dim objects. Now over here is where we noted that anytime the moon gets around east, it's when it puts out that reflection. It puts it out before then, but the best one's about east, where it makes the reflection, that right there. And like I say, it's the same reflection we're seeing now, and we've seen it in between the camera and the building. So it's pretty obvious that this is nothing but a reflection off the moon, and happens when the moon is in about the same place every time. So that was last year, and this year we're seeing the same thing again. You know, we can go over here and look at it in this window, and this particular time right here, 2230 or 2240 on the 16th, I got those downloaded, and we can look at them here. And this is the one looking southeast right here at the base. Here's the moon here. Here's the one that's up on top of the base looking south. Now the base is oriented north and south, so it's looking south. It's looking down towards the moon right here, the one on top of this one here. And this is the moon, but that's the moon too. But this camera is set to see things really dim, has exposure setting really set really long. This one over here is not. That's why you can't see anything around here. It's black. But this is the same time. This is on the 16th at 2240, 16th at 2240. And one camera sees the moon like that, and the other camera sees the moon like that. And you see there it goes up into the clouds and whatnot. But if you work it on through, it come up with the next day, and there's your solar reflection. Well, the sun's over here about east, about where the moon is when it makes that reflection. And not only that, but this particular time right here, this is on the 17th at 6:30, right at sunrise. You see it over here, it's right at sunrise, 6:30 on the 17th. And you know, you even have the flares over here too. But notice that cloud bank. You got a humongous cloud bank right here, and the sun is just peeking in between the horizon and the cloud bank. This is the cloud bank, and you're seeing this reflection right on top of the cloud bank. Now, there's no way that little reflection or whatever that is going to be shining through that cloud bank. And here's more reflections over here on top of the cloud bank. And if you take and look at it, the sun won't even shine through that cloud bank. It's right there, the sun disappears again because it's behind the cloud bank. The same cloud bank that somehow or another, this object over here is peeking through that cloud bank, and the bottom half of it should be brighter than, the sun, and it's not. This is a reflection. It's on top of a cloud bank. It's in the same position as the sun. The sun gets over about east, moon gets over about east, you get a reflection off this camera. So that's what you're looking at there. And like I said, here's one camera that's set for a different setting, and the other camera set for a different setting, and you're going to see completely different things. You're going to see things really bright on this camera here, where they are not bright over here on this camera here, even though it's the same moon, the same time. So just thought I'd clear that up for you there. So let's go on to the NEOs. This was 2240 where the moon position was. Station's about 140. So it is possible on those two cameras to get the moon at the same time. And when you read this again, just remember, view from the communications radome to the north side of the base. That's the north side of the base. You can't be looking north if you're looking at the north side of the base. You're looking southwest or southeast right here. And the other one is up on top of the building. It's from the roof. And you're looking to the south. So you're right up here on this little spot right there, looking the length, down length of the station. So you will get a little bit of the same location on the two cameras like we just saw. Okay, so back to the NEOs. We can go over to the, or we could just mosey on ahead to 6:30 on the 17th. And you see that, yes, the sun was rising, just peaked over the horizon at 6:30 on the 17th, and here's east right here. And that is about the same location the moon is when it makes its reflection on that camera. Now, let's go back to the NEOs. Here are the NEOs. We have a new floor mat here. Started getting data from the Lowell Observatory. And when you do that, there is so much data here, so many asteroids. It's like 583,000 asteroids. There's no way you can list all of them. So what I've decided to do is just take and list everything that's within 6 tenths of an AU. You look over here, you can look at the asteroids and set it for the distance here. And this will show the asteroids that are the closest. And you can go down the list and check the ones that are within a certain distance. And I've checked all the ones that are closer than 6.6 AU. And you can look down here. These are all the ones that I don't have listed. The reason that most of these are listed as 2012 is because there's just so many of them. It's either, you get 1 year. And so I chose 2012. And the ones that are not in 2012 that are close are in this section here called User Created. And those are the ones that happened earlier, that were discovered earlier, that are still pretty close. You can see the distance right down here. And I again went to 0.6 AU, anything closer than 0.6 AU. And that one there, don't make the cut. So anything within 6.6 AU is on the screen. And we can take and zoom in on it a little bit here. And the biggest things to look out for are going to be coming up here. We'll look at the diagram right here. I guess this is what they call a Mars crossing asteroid here. And, it's an NEO. And it's going to be coming up on April 1st. So we'll pay attention to that date. Hopefully the date won't skip too much on here. The other ones to pay attention to is right here, 2012 FG, that was 1.6. 2012 EN5, that was 1.4 lunar distance. EL8 was 7.3. Those have all passed. These are the ones coming up. And we have 2012 EO8 at 3.6. And scroll on down from there. And then we have our 2012 EG5. That's 0.6 lunar distance. And if you take and average that out, it's going to be somewhere around maybe 60 meters or so, somewhere in that area. They give a pretty big spread here, everything from 38 meters to 85 meters, so that's a humongous spread. And what else is coming close? Not much. We've got 2007 HV4 here at 4.8, and 1992 JD at 9.5 lunar distance, and KK37 at 2.3, that's near the end of it. And of course, they could discover one tomorrow or this afternoon, and it might come closer. That's how that works. And you go back to this one here. I put the distance in. It's this distance right here, close approach on the first. And that would work out to 143,843 miles at its closest approach. So we'll start over here and get it running. And speed it up to about 30,000. And you can see the ones coming in close. Here's your 2012 EA. Here comes the DH-54. It doesn't look like the Earth is centered again. So we'll center the Earth back again. And we'll put it on the scroll. And start it again. Let's see, you scroll it around and it looks a little bit different there. And there goes a fast one. Which one was that? 2012 DH4. Here's the EN5 and the EL8. About the only way you're going to be able to read these is if you look at it in high definition. Anything else, you're not going to be able to see the numbers. There goes the arrow indicating the direction the Earth is traveling on its orbit. EK5 over here. There goes your FG, 2012 FG. And here comes the EG5 coming up in this direction. We'll take and zoom in a little bit on it there. And we can put the moon's orbit on there too. And the way it gets closest, I've found out, is if you look at it from above, looking down, that would be about like that. And I'll run it again. And you see it coming by the moon here and then passing the Earth within 0.6 lunar distance. So it looks like it's going to be going in front of us. Roll it back up this way. And it will look like that from that angle. And we can zoom back out a little bit. And comes your 2007 HV4. Here comes your 1992 JD. They say the only thing that's highlighted right now is anything that's within 0.6 AU. And here's the last one over here, 2010 KK37. That's the one that's going to be, I think it's 2.3 lunar distances away. and talk to you next time.